So I just prepared like a short little thing today. But no, that series, Play the Man, was pretty big for me. This is something that I've been doing for like the last 2 years. And I looked up some stuff last night, and this is perfect because this is everything that I have actually been implementing in my life for the last 2 years. And it was like right there online when I was looking up some stuff for today. But I wanted to talk about what I believe a true biblical man is, and that what that looks like in my life, and what I've been doing for the last 2 years. So like, you know, step one, my first ministry is my home. True discipleship begins in my house. I'm the leader of my home. I'm the king, the priest, and the prophet. That's how I look at myself, of my home. The king, because I rule over my with authority in my house, with love, with God's word, with direction, with care. I'm the priest because I intercede for my family on behalf of my family to God in prayer. I take the lead in that. And as the prophet, I speak on God's behalf to my family. So that's my responsibility. Lead, initiate, be a man of action. Assume it is your job and your moment. Hate apathy. Reject passivity. Before I can lead others, I must lead my family. So that's number one for me. Number two, speaking out. And you guys know that I do that a lot. Silence in the midst of sin is sin. I speak out against sin. If something's wrong, if I'm seeing something being done that's wrong, I'm in myself first, I'm going to change it. I'm going to ask God for help and prayer, and then I'm going to address it with others because I love my brothers. I love my family. Be courageous. Fear God, not man. I wholeheartedly believe that and speak the truth in love. So that's number two for me on biblical manhood. Number three, stand strong. Don't give in when you are challenged, attacked, or criticized. That's something that I hold on to in my faith. I believe the Word of God is the inspired Word of God. And I believe in healing. I believe in the infilling of the Holy Spirit. I believe with faith that the Word is what it says. And Jesus is who He says He is. And He told us what we can do and how we should walk. I wholeheartedly believe that. I have been attacked for that. I have been criticized and I have been challenged. My whole life for believing in that. But as a man of God, I stand strong in my faith regardless of what the world says, even regardless of what other people say, even within the church. And a scripture that God gave me last year was in Jeremiah 1:18 on this. And this has been a huge part of my walk. And this was given to the prophet Jeremiah. It says, "Now behold, I made you today as a fortified city, and as a pillar of iron, and as walls of bronze against the whole land, to the kings of Judah, to the princes, to the priests, and to the people of the land. They will fight against you, but they will not overcome you. They will not prevail against you, for I am with you to deliver you, declares the Lord." So that's part of my walk of being a man of God, regardless of the attacks, the criticism, the things that happen. I repeat myself a lot because I believe this, and this is what I say what I believe in my heart. And I'm not afraid to be attacked or criticized or challenged on that. And that was number three. Number four is stay humble. This is something that I've been looking at for the last year, really, really looking at this, and it's be vigilant against pride. Get the log out of your eye. I'm always saying that. If any of you guys know me on Monday night, I'm always talking about taking the log out of your eye. I look at myself first and foremost before I look at anybody else. What am I doing? How am I walking? How am I addressing my life and my family? And what am I doing? So I really believe that. Take the log out of your eye. And don't think less of yourself, but think of yourself less. And number five is we serve the King. Seek first His kingdom, His glory, and His righteousness. Hope in eternity, and live for a greater reward. This is what we're doing here. We're this is a training ground. And I'm not just looking at the temporary, what I'm doing here right now. What am I doing right now that's going to echo through eternity? And in Romans 14:12, it says, so then each of us will give an account of ourselves to God. And I truly believe that. One day I'm going to stand before God and give an account for my life and what I've done. What have I done with his name? What have I done with his word, with those red letters, with the freedom that he's given me? How did I share my faith and how did I walk? So I truly believe that everything that I teach, everything that I say, and everything that I do, I'm going to take an account for God one day. And I posted this in GroupMe, and I don't know, some of you probably read it, but I'm going to read it today because I thought this was very powerful. This was a time of prayer and meditation that the Lord gave us to me. And it says, men, let us not take the authority that God has given us over our wives, families, and ministries lightly. With all respect, let us lead as we submit ourselves under our Lord Jesus Christ and be guided by his Holy Spirit. I pray that we stay strong in our leadership and love, without wavering the truth of the word. Let us stay in continuous prayer, testing all doctrine and experiences we have by the word of God, that we ourselves, along with our families, may not be deceived. Men, we must stay accountable to each other, as one day we will be accountable before our Lord. Our wives are not to rule over us, but to be our helpers. The weight of leadership has always been made for us to carry on our shoulders. Let our wives, our families, our communities take rest and confidence in us as we show them what true submission is, by submitting completely under the leadership of Christ in every way. So that being said, I have a contract here, and looking at and the play the man was a pretty big deal for me. So my son just turned 14 this last week on Wednesday. And I brought him here today because I want to acknowledge him in a rite of passage into manhood. Yeah. So he is no longer a child, but a man today.
Hallelujah!
And this is a sword that I got as a symbol of the word of God that we wield. And that he's going to submit himself under the leadership and the authority that God has placed over him. And so I want him to come up and read this declaration as his rite of passage and his declaration of what he's going to do for a man today.
I do solemnly resolve before God to take full responsibility for myself, my walk, and my leadership with him. I will submit under accountability and authority of God and other men of God. I will love God's people, protect the weak, serve my family, my church, my school, and community. I will learn and teach the word of God as I grow into a spiritual leader. I will be faithful to God in mind, body, and spirit. I will love and honor God and be willing to lay down my life for the gospel of Jesus Christ, crucified and resurrected. I will train and live to honor authority and live responsibly. I will confront evil, pursue justice, and love mercy. I will pray for others and treat them with kindness, respect, and compassion. I will work diligently to provide for the needs of my family and others. I will forgive those who have wronged me and reconcile with those I have wronged. I will learn from my mistakes, repent of my sins, and I will walk with integrity as a man answerable to God. I will seek to honor God, be faithful to his church, obey his word, and do his will. I will courageously work with the strength God provides to fulfill this resolution for the rest of my life and for his glory. As for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. Joshua 24:15.
Something. Good morning. My name
is Tom Smith. Try not to get choked up. Vince and I have a very special bond and relationship. For the first 9 years of his life, he and his mom, my daughter Jessica, lived at home with my wife and I. And in that time, forged the bond that we have today. I was a male, a role model in Vince's life, and I love Vince more than words. So it's hard for me to fathom how much Christ loves us, because I love this young man so much, and I'm so proud of him. Vince, I want you to know, and I think you know that, I would lay down my life for you. I treasured you, our relationship, and I am so proud of you this morning. And the young man you are growing into, and I praise God for the influence that Jacob has over my daughter and Vince. And it takes a special man to love and raise somebody else's child. And I am so thankful for God. And I'm so blessed and privileged to take part in this celebration today. Thank you.
For us to come around Vince and pray for him as he enters his manhood today.
Lord, I ask that his steps be righteous, Father, that you guide him along this path and declare that you are Lord, and he will serve you all his days. We love you, Lord. It's in Jesus' mighty name we pray this.
I want you to repeat after me in your loudest, manliest voice. Amen. That's what you are. You're a man today. You understand? Amen. So I want you to just to cry out a prayer for me. Just repeat after me. Amen. Say, Father, I cry out to you.
Father, I cry out to you.
Amen. God, thank you for saving me.
For saving me.
Thank you for redeeming me.
Thank you for redeeming me.
Father, here I am.
Father, here I am.
I will answer the call.
I will answer the call.
I am a warrior.
I'm a warrior.
I'm a shooter.
I'm a shooter.
And I will take the shot.
And I will take the shot.
In Jesus' mighty name.
In Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.